Although he's been singing professionally since 1979, it wasn't until 2 years ago that Chris Isaak first rocked the charts with a hit called Wicked Game. Chris Isaak has just released his fourth album. It's called San Francisco Days. Fitting the title, it's already mining gold. Chris, how you doing?
Doing real good.
Good morning. All's well?
Yeah, everything's good. I brought Kenny along with me.
Good seeing you again, Kenny.
Right, my pleasure.
We actually did this together up in the Bay Area, what, six years ago?
Yep. Yeah.
Now, back then, you were hardly a struggling artist, but you also weren't the star you are today. Yeah, you had any doubt it would come to this?
We were working full-time back then, yeah.
I know you were getting a paycheck,
we had full-time work, yeah.
You were getting a paycheck, but it wasn't big-time like it is now, huh?
Oh, it was big. It was big. Buku's bucks.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What, 50 a week?
All the sardines I can eat.
Something like that. Wicked Game actually became a hit song, what, 2 years after the album was released?
I don't even know. To tell you the truth, I was like, the album came out, and I remember being back home in San Francisco. We had like a break for like a week on tour, and I was watching like Hawaii Five-O every night, laying on the couch, and people kept calling me and saying, they're playing your record, and I was going, that's nice, good, great. And then...
The story goes that a guy in Atlanta saw the movie Wild at Heart.
Lee Chestnut, but who remembers?
But who remembers that kind of stuff? Yeah. Saw the movie, liked the song, started playing it, and it caught on. I was just wondering what that says about your business and how it makes you feel. I mean,
Lee Chestnut is a genius, man.
Right? Exactly.
Yeah.
But doesn't it say something about the inherent worth of any song? I mean, being unless somebody comes to the fair?
That's the cool thing about music. Everybody's got their favorites that weren't hits, you know? That you can turn people on to stuff that you go, listen to this thing. It's like a B-side on a Jerry Lee Lewis track or something that should have been a hit but wasn't, you know?
Yeah. I was, speaking of Jerry Lee Lewis, I was going over some of your stuff last night, and I read something that although you cite his influences, guys like Jerry Lee and Elvis and Roy Orbison, you don't take too kindly to ideas that just sound kind of like them. Why?
Well, I don't think I do sound like them because if people, they bought a record of mine trying to, you know, hope that it would sound like Elvis or something like that, I think they'd be disappointed. You know, if they want to hear those kind of singers, they should buy those records. I like them, but influence, I think the influences are there, but, you know, comparing yourself to those people is kind of tough. It's like standing next to the Queen Mary or something, you know?
Mm.
You look real small.
Kenny and I were teasing you a little bit earlier about your budding film career. You had... brief spots in Married to the Mob and Silence.
I feel a song coming on.
In Silence of the Lambs, but you're a star now, I understand.
Yeah.
You got the lead role in a movie.
Well, yeah, that's what they tell me so far, but you never know what they're going to edit out, you know. But this time I was pretty good, and I did this, Bernardo Bertolucci made a film called Little Buddha, but this time I stood, like, when anybody's talking, I stand with my head, like, right by their shoulder.
Mm-hmm.
So that pretty much it's hard to edit me out.
Mm-hmm. That's pretty good stuff.
You learn these things as you go along.
I got you. Yeah. I got you. Understood. You carry a gun in this one too? The new one?
No gun in this one.
No gun. We were just talking about every movie he's in. He has to carry a gun. Could be worse. Could be a mop.
First time. Yeah.
What are you singing today?
Solitary Man.
Yeah. Okay.
Ready, buddy?
Linda was mine till the time that I found her, holding Jim, loving him. Sue came along, loved me strong, that's what I thought. Me and Sue, that died too. Don't know if I will, but until I can find it, girl who will stay and won't play games behind me, I'll know what I have. Solitary man, solitary man. I had it to hear me and where love's a small world. Paper ring, part-time playing. No, it's been done having one girl who loves you, right or wrong, weak or strong. Don't know if I will, but until I can find it, girl who will stay and won't play games behind solitary man, solitary man.
Nice stuff. As I say Thanks. Goodbye, did I mention that Wicked Game had made you somewhat of a sex symbol?
Do I look sexy?
I don't know. I was asking you. Chris, good seeing you again.
Thanks very much.
Okay,
don't
let it be another 6 years. Stay well. See you, Kenny.
All right, Brian. All right,
thanks.
Take care of that monitor.
Thank you. We'll take a break. This is Today on NBC. You know what I was noticing when we were talking?